huge Babylonia. How much medicine in Babylonian Babylon, in ancient, not necessarily going to find everything that we consider medicine on the modern scene. In the study that I mentioned before, Professor Geller writes, surgery was virtually unknown, both in Babylonian and Talmudic medicine. Of course, I find myself studying a very famous passage describing in detail, Talmudic passage describing in detail liposuction surgery complete with anesthesia. So it appears that there is surgery in Babylonian medicine. However, if one were to establish what appears as a clear conclusion, he would be very mistaken. Because this type of surgery, which Rabbi Elazar, Rabbi Shimon, had himself undergo in order to prove his virtue, by its very literary, the very nature of its literary setting, clearly it shows, it should convince anyone, how unmedical, non-medical, and non-realistic this type of description is. But even so, it's interesting to know where these ideas came from, and where they came from further establishes the conclusion, I believe, that this is not medicine at all, and not at all happening in reality, even in the scientific sense. The badik nafshei, the examination that one does in order to come to a determination that is reflected in this event of Rabbi Shimon, seems to flow from certain medical situations in which this phrase was used, and people did badik nafshei and see what the results of a certain medicines were that they were taking. And it also comes from another area where badika is known very well, from the ritual slaughtering in which such examinations were known. So a passage that describes surgery and tells you what the results were of the surgery in terms of the finding, was there fat, was there blood, were there veins, was there shurai kisumke, what exactly are shurai kisumke, on the one hand, comes from one author who is the author of the fantastic literary descriptions of the stories in the Babylonian Talmud. But the continuation comes from the anonymous voice of the Talmud, the Baal Stama Talmud, who always likes to raise questions from one area to the other. And he says, well, so why, how come did they find their veins? I'll claim eventually that these are not really veins that have been discussed. Did they find blood? Where did he get these ideas? Does this represent anatomy? Does this at least mean that they know what is there in the inside of the human body, and they can speak of it in terms of terminology and very certain questions? Taking a look at the use of this phrase, suraikis tsumke, we can really suggest where it was originally used and how it was transferred from one field to the other until it ended up in this area. And where it came from, again, was ritual slaughter, and the appearance of the parts of the slaughtered animal, and the decision as to whether there was blood and other such things, which was used by Baal's Stama Talmud in some more, well, perhaps imaginary, but certainly more picturesque situations, like the rooster's crown, and eventually in this description of surgery. So the specific studies and publications that Professor Geller has already given us lead us into some of these ideas that can be so helpful take back home to the basic discipline of the Talmudic studies